Valley and other in-depth places is down below a dozen. I mean, she said 30 seconds is the exact number. What is it? 37. All right. Now, I'm going to answer that, and you may not agree with my answer because I don't have statistical proof of this. And I'm taken with trying to do first with the facts on the table, then arguing rather than coming at it from ideology. But I believe, so this is an I believe, you know, when my daughter had cancer, I wanted a doctor in the United States. I'm sure there's been ones elsewhere. See, I honestly feel the quality of healthcare we have here, if you have access to it, is premium. And so, if you were able to have everyone have access to that quality of care and be able to afford it, I believe you would be up there with other countries, if not even above. But I don't have a study that can show you that that's true. Pardon me? No, you have to be, you're not wrong. There are, it's like that tort reform question. I mean, now, and part of that is, you know, my father had a staph infection. Let me just tell you, a staph infection cost the hospital about $140,000. And they're very preventable. I think it's the VA hospital in Pittsburgh, they hardly have any staph infections. Why? Because it's mandated, you will change your gown 7-8 times a day. You will wash your hands out. So very preventive ways to do things. Changing the incentives and all have a way to do it. And I think it's the hospital, the VA in Pittsburgh. Take medicine. I remember checking, and I'm a Navy guy with details. And so whenever the chemo went down, I took down the bag and checked it. We found 2 mistakes. Now they were minor mistakes, but you get electronic. You know, when the pharmacist types it in, it goes all the wires right into the back. You know, you can stop some of this. And so there's some, but these are hard things to convince people that they're worth the initial payment because the savings are tended down the road. Now, the second part of your question was, oh, you remember? Look, this is what we're doing tonight. I know Chris from a year or two. I mean, the group of men and women that he goes around with, or he's been where I have in Panama. I respect that man. He and I have, he has my cell phone. He called me today because he had heard that we were, that seats had been passed out by tickets, and that's unfair. I said, absolutely not right. I asked, I said, is this, and he said, no. Look, my part of what, unfortunately, politics has become is the art of cleverness. Being able to make your case by innuendo and other things. But all that said, I'm telling everybody here that if you've been with me when I traveled throughout this wonderful commonwealth, people are anxious. And it's our job to do this. Bill Walsh, I went to the Navy in 1997, keeps our office open 7 days a week. Call us tomorrow night. He's here today at 9 o'clock at night. Because we belong in the military. I mean, people think military are clones. Well, you see here they're not. They have opinions. But you listen to your troops and you're accessible to them if you're a decent leader. And that's how we approach it. Government for too long has not been accountable in the sense of, you know, it's been my job to be up here and do this. I mean, Bill today has been trying to arrange for another town hall in Upper Darby to do this. And we're going to do it. We're having one of those telecommuting calls, but I didn't want to run the telecommuting ones until September because I didn't want anybody saying, oh, you're hiding behind the telephone. You know what I mean? I don't mind this stuff. I love this stuff. Because it's my job to get back. And look, to be quite frank, I think the Democrats can have done a better job, quite frankly, over the past 8 months. And we tend to talk among ourselves and bring cult caps Old to Newcastle. Anybody under 50 doesn't understand.